just laughter and his smile. Kid was so full of life. Walked in a room and made a friend everywhere he went.
A mother should never have to grieve the loss of her son. But on Sunday, Lisa Hutchison is doing just that. Her son, Curtis, was killed last April after being hit by a boat in Little River. He was just 26 years old.
The rest is out at sea, and now I get to come here, and since I live here, and be able to come and see my son.
This simple piece of stone gives Hutchison a place to heal and brings together a community to surround her and offer comfort. Curtis was the 30th name to be added to the Lost at Sea Memorial in Murrells Inlet.
And it's in a perfect spot because it looks out over the inlet, right where the boats come in and out when they go fishing.
Brenda Brown and her family created the granite monument after their son, Johnny Brown, disappeared when his fishing boat was caught in a storm.
I told my husband one year when we were getting ready, I said, I can't do this no more. It's like I'm going to Johnny's funeral year after year after year.
But after seeing the faces of all those who have lost loved ones at sea, Brown knows that she has no choice but to keep their memories alive. At Sunday's ceremony, organizers rang a bell and said each name on the stone, now 30 names in all.
When someone's off sea and you have no body, you don't have a grave to go to on birthdays, Christmas, stuff like that.
This statue gives families somewhere to go so their loved ones are never forgotten.
It's just something to give you a little comfort, that make you feel like you're doing something for them.
In Murrells Inlet, Mark Liverman, WPDE News Channel 15.